welcome to Elon After Hours. I'm Hunter Riccio.
And I'm Samantha Palazzi. Tonight we have a great show for you guys, but first let's get into some news. Mm-hmm. Since Elon football did play this past weekend and lost, it's because the head coach did not watch our show for the first time.
There it is.
So let's turn our good luck attention to Elon basketball, because it seems like they need some love. Over the past weekend, they played the big bad Duke University. And they lost 97-68. It's okay. Elon After Hours and our five viewers are here for you.
In other very serious news, Melania Trump decided to pay a visit to Gugu the panda. Yes, Gugu. And she decided to meet and stroke the paw of the panda who mauled three people. But the best part about this story is after meeting the friendly panda behind bars, she tweeted out, "So wonderful to meet Gugu." Can we just please get like a picture of this in the middle of this like wonderful interaction here? And also, rogue Twitter employee, can you please come back and save us from this other Trump as well?
Yes, I completely agree. Mm. More in international news, a couple in Canada has spent the last 50 years making a nuclear war shelter. It is a total of 10,000 square feet and made out of 42 buried school buses. Yeah. It can hold up to 350 people. Hunter, you can be one of these people.
Me?
If you volunteer on site and work on the shelter, you get a free entry pass in the event of a nuclear attack.
All right, that sounds great and all. Like, I would love to be a person, but why are there 42 buried school buses somewhere? Did they dig those holes and then put the school buses in it?
I mean, you'd have to ask them.
All right, I'm gonna go ask them. Stay tuned for our next episode on that one. All right, so Montemore local news. The beloved Lambda fraternity here at Elon has been suspended until the fall of 2021. I know. The reason for the suspension is, quote, multiple violations. So many thoughts come to mind when someone leaves such an open statement like that in the paper. Samantha, isn't 2021 the year you graduate?
Yes, it is, Hunter. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna graduate in the spring. So I won't get to see the Lambda return.
So sad to hear.
Yeah, I will be very sad. But I do have some more interesting news.
Oh, good.
There's a group of nuns living in Merced, California, who make soaps and oils from marijuana.
Yeah, that makes sense, okay.
They are called the Sisters of the Valley, and they actually make a lot of money each year selling these things by using their special ingredient, which they call the gift from God.
Oh, yes.
I guess this means Seth Rogen and James Franco are about to try and become the first ever male nuns.
And they'll probably make a movie about it. When we come back, I will be sitting down with two members of the new business fraternity, DSP. You won't want to miss it.
What are you, superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day, I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the way I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Kevin and the Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the rinse cycle.
Separate. Cook.
Fire in the hole.
And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
Your daughter just had her first breakup. Do you A, put yourself in her shoes? B, console her?
Don't worry, sweetie. This is gonna happen a lot.
Or C, find her a new boyfriend?
Nice single boys. That was weird.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Here's to the things that can keep us safe. Those we use all the time with hardly a thought. Those that are silently standing by to save our lives. And now, those that we carry with us everywhere we go. Many mobile devices will now bring you wireless emergency alerts, real-time information directly from local sources you know and trust. With a unique sound and vibration, you'll be in the know, wherever you are.
All right, welcome back to Elon After Hours. I'm here with Alyssa and Frankie from the new business fraternity, DSP. All right, how are you guys doing today?
Swell, how are
Swell.
You?
I'm doing good. My first question is to you.
Okay.
Do you think I'm cute?
Oh my gosh, I guess, maybe. Probably okay. See me after dinner or something. For
Just
me.
Wondering, are you free this weekend?
No, actually.
Okay, anyways, so. Frankie, this question goes to you. So what is DSP and what does it stand for? Like what kind of is DSP altogether?
It's Delta Sigma Pi.
Awesome.
And it is a professional business fraternity that is co-ed. It has over 275,000 members worldwide. And we brought it here to Elon's campus.
So how long did it take to get DSP up and running?
It's been over 2 years now.
Yeah.
Oh, so a quick transit, right?
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah. Quick and easy.
It was first a colony, and now it's officially a chapter as of a few days ago. And it was founded, our colony was brought to Elon on October 20th, 2015. So it's literally been over 2 years. And Frankie started it literally from the ground up, and her sophomore year we started.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and she's a senior now, so.
What made you? Oh,
did it's been a while. No, it's
sorry, I'm so
been
sorry.
A while.
Okay. So, what made you want to start DSP at Elon? Like, what even sparked your interest or idea?
Yeah, a good question.
Thank you. It's my job.
When I was a sophomore in September, I went to all the interest meetings for all the business organizations and other fraternities offered on campus, and I didn't find anything that I liked. Not to say that the ones offered are bad or not a good fit for other people, mm-hmm. just wasn't a good fit for myself. So I called my parents, and they joked, saying that you should start your own fraternity. And I was like, okay, great. Yeah. Yeah, really funny.
Thanks, Mom and Dad.
That night, I couldn't sleep, pulled out my laptop, searched co-ed business fraternities. Delta Sigma Pi was the first one that popped up, emailed them, and got the approval to start the colony.
So you said fraternity, but you guys are like both girls.
Yeah.
What is that? No, I'm just kidding. But I have been asked this. Why is it called a fraternity and not a sorority?
Yeah, people actually correct me when I say I'm in a fraternity. They say, oh, you mean sorority? And
oh,
I go, no.
No.
Delta Sigma Pi is the first professional organization nationally that allowed women to join, and it's because they saw a growing interest of women in business. So it was a fraternity, and it was only allowed males at first, mm-hmm. but due to the great deal of women joining the business world, they allowed women to join.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's really cool. Mm-hmm. I had no idea.
Fun fact.
So I have a question for you now.
Yes.
What's your favorite thing about DSP?
Well, so far my favorite thing has just been creating it with Frankie and with everyone else on exec. Like, it's an awesome team, and it's just like it's really cool to see it go from the ground up, because it kind of came literally from nothing. And the first time I heard about it, we had a class together, and I overheard her talking to people about this new like idea that she's going to pitch to the business school, and I was like, wow, that sounds great, let me know what I can do. And so the best part has just been literally just helping and like watching it grow. So from here on out, I'm not really sure what would be my favorite part, but probably just watching it create, stay established at, become established, I guess, at
yeah.
Elon.
Cool.
And Alyssa's been with it since day one.
Since day
like
one
she's
as well.
Literally one of the day ones.
She's pretty cool then, right? So what is your least favorite thing, Frankie, about DSP that you want to share?
That's so hard. You
wanted that right to
you. I know. That's so hard. My least favorite part.
You don't have to say it. We can move on to another question. If
no,
you
I can think of something. It wouldn't be something super negative. I guess my least favorite part is that it's only, I can't bring it back with me after graduation.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I'll just be a member of it in the sense that I'm a brother, but it's not something that I can be a part of mm-hmm. every single day, 24 hours a day, every single day of the week. So
that's
I think really that's my negative. That's
that
my only.
That's really cute. That's like a positive negative.
Literally 24/7. It's been like.
Yes. Sometimes I wake up with nightmares.
She like texts me at 3 a.m. sometimes asking me things about it. I'm like, go to sleep.
Crazy. So why can't I join DSP? I mean, I've been turned down like 3 times.
Well, what's your major?
I'm a TV and cinema major.
Yeah, that's your problem.
It's
you
my
need to be a business
problem?
Major to be in DSP.
Yes, or sport and event management. Yeah. That is only approved for Elon, fun fact.
That's okay. I'm not hurt at all.
It's not too late. You have a semester. You can switch over to business.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I think, I mean, you might need to stay a little longer.
I mean, are you in business?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
I have to be because I'm in DSP.
Okay. So how many people are in DSP, like right now? Like your, I was going to say colony.
Now we're chapter,
that
yeah.
Your chapter, because that's really new.
We have, including abroad people, I believe the number is 64, and then 2 faculty initiates and mm-hmm. 1 that is planned to be initiated in during winter term.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's and actually, fun fact, to date, the biggest, right? Including
mm-hmm.
the abroad numbers. If you include abroad numbers, our colony becoming a chapter, our installation was the biggest installation that Delta Sigma Pi has had internationally, like up to this point.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys so much for coming in. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have. Thank you, Alyssa and Frankie. Up next, Samantha will be interviewing and playing a game with DJ Ben. You won't want to miss it.
Yay!
Your daughter just had her first breakup. Do you A, put yourself in her shoes? B, console her.
Don't worry, sweetie. This is gonna happen a lot.
Or C, find her a new boyfriend.
Nice single boys. That was weird.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Can you help me with this? My new dad teaches me all kinds of stuff.
Sure.
He helps me with homework.
That would be 3.6795.
Thanks.
Yep.
He helps me with my decision making.
I wouldn't use this one. Ever.
And he's even teaching me how to drive.
And that's why cars have bumpers.
I'm learning so much.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of kids in foster care will take you just as you are.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day, I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the ways I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Here's to the things that can keep us safe. Those we use all the time with hardly a thought. Those that are silently standing by to save our lives. And now, those that we carry with us everywhere we go. Many mobile devices will now bring you wireless emergency alerts, real-time information directly from local sources you know and trust. With a unique sound and vibration, you'll be in the know wherever you are.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. That's 1 in 5 daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. Yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need. Visit feedingamerica.org to help them feed even more. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
Welcome back to Elon After Hours. We are here with DJ Ben, and we're going to do a short interview and then get into our fun little game. All right, Ben, my first question for you is, when did you first know you wanted to be a DJ? And generally, like, when were you first interested in music?
First interested in music was ever since I was born, really. I asked for my first guitar at, like, age 1 or 2, and I got it that day. I played it till my fingers bled, and then put band-aids on and kept playing. Had guitar lessons for like 7 or 8 years. Learned drums, piano, a bunch of other stuff. Started DJing late middle school, early high school. And I realized as I kind of showed other people what I could do, I was like, oh, I could like make this a thing. And kind of took it from there.
That's awesome. So yeah, kind of related to that, what made you want to start DJing?
In middle school, I got my first MacBook. I'd saved up for like a couple of years, and then got my first MacBook Pro, and then played around with like GarageBand and like started making mashups, just downloading instrumentals and vocal tracks and trying to find ones that worked well together. And then one day I was like, you know, I want to do this live. It's like I want to, you know, do live and do multiple. I want to like do stuff on the fly and like perform with this. Got a DJ board and then was like, oh, I can like do other things. I can do parties. I can do a lot more than just mashups.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Thanks.
Okay, last question. What is your favorite part about being a DJ?
Favorite part about being a DJ is kind of making the crowd happy. My happiness comes almost entirely from making others happy. So making entire crowds excited when they hear songs that they like or drops that they weren't expecting is like the most, like the greatest feeling.
That's awesome. Okay, well, it is National Clean Out Your Fridge Day.
Is it really?
So I have a very fun game for us. So we're gonna do 2 truths and a lie,
oh boy,
but kind of like fridge edition.
Okay.
So I'm gonna tell you 3 things that people have found in their fridge, but 2 of them are true, 1 of them is a lie. Okay?
Okay.
Here's your first one. So an iPhone inside of a risotto. 2nd one, an old heart valve in saline solution. And the 3rd one is a cup of crickets. Which one do you think is a lie?
I'm gonna go with the iPhone.
Ah, oh, you were wrong. It was the cup of crickets.
Okay.
Okay, so what you have to do, since you were wrong, we're gonna do, you're gonna have to do a pretzel for 5 seconds.
Define pretzel.
So pretzel is when you wrap your legs around each other, you wrap your arms around each other, and you try and balance for five seconds.
I like standing up.
Yep, so we're gonna go over here.
Oh boy.
You can do it.
Looking over here.
So wrap your legs around each other, wrap your arms, squat a little bit, and you gotta hold it for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, you got it. You can do this. You're a pro. Awesome. Okay.
That was hard.
No, you got it. It was good. 2nd round. Okay. A wedding band behind the condiments. A taxidermied black duck in the freezer. Technically not the fridge, the freezer. And then ice cream with a tooth in it.
Ooh. I'm gonna go with the first one.
The wedding band?
Yeah.
Oh, so close. It was the ice cream with the tooth in it.
Oh.
Okay, this one you don't have to get up for. So what we're gonna do, you're gonna put your hand like this.
Like?
Mm-hmm, so middle finger down on the,
yep. Okay.
And so all fingers touching the table. Kay. And you're gonna try and lift your ring finger. Without moving your middle finger, you have to lift your ring finger off the table.
Like out, like put it back out, like straight.
Like you have to move your like this finger, and you have to lift it up, without moving any of your other fingers. It's really, really hard. Most people can't do it.
I cannot. how do you?
It's really hard. Most people can't do it. I don't know if I can do it.
I can't do it at all.
Oh, I got it. Look, do you see it? It's like a little bit. It's like a little bit.
Oh, my God.
You got That's it. Cool. It's okay.
I didn't know that was a thing.
Okay, third round. A Beanie Baby black cat toy, a sheep brain, and a Venus flytrap.
Venus flytrap.
Good job. Hey. You got it right. Okay, last one. We're going to do a DVD, the family cat, and an old baked potato that had maggots in it.
A DVD.
No, so close though. It was the baked potato with maggots.
Ew. Oh, God.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
You got it. It's fine. Okay, we got to stand up for this one.
Oh, gosh.
So what we're going to do, you're going to balance on one foot. So let's go over here again.
Okay.
You're going to balance on one foot, and you got to rub your stomach, pat your head. That's it.
Bounce on one foot, rub stomach, pat head.
Look at that. You got it. That was easy. You got it. All right. Thank you for joining
Thank
us.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Stay tuned, everybody. DJ Ben is going to be back for his performance.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day, I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the ways I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
I want to eat apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I eat?
1 in 5 children struggles with hunger in America. Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
What are you, superheroes?
Just 4 brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with 4 simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the rinse cycle.
Separate. Cook.
Fire in the hole.
And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
Your daughter just had her first breakup. Do you A, put yourself in her shoes? B, console her?
Don't worry, sweetie. This is gonna happen a lot.
Or C, find her a new boyfriend?
Nice, single boys. That was weird.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Here's to the things that can keep us safe. Those we use all the time with hardly a thought. Those that are silently standing by to save our lives. And now, those that we carry with us everywhere we go. Many mobile devices will now bring you wireless emergency alerts, real-time information directly from local sources you know and trust. With a unique sound and vibration, you'll be in the know, wherever you are.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. That's 1 in 5 daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Elon After Hours. I'm here with Ben Waters, a.k.a. BTW. So, BTW, what are you going to play for us tonight?
I'm going to play a quick mini-mix from the set that I did when I opened for John Bellion here at the Homecoming concert a couple weeks ago. Quick, you know, like 4-minute set, all songs that are harmonically in key with each other, hopefully songs that everyone knows, and hopefully a little surprise in there, too.
Awesome. Well, audience, enjoy.
Thanks.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in tonight. Thank you again, BTW.
Thank you
to the girls from DSP. And I hope you guys have a good night.
Thanks. Woo!